In this video, we will discuss about how to evaluate this Dirac delta function using Scilab. The question will be like this: evaluate this Dirac delta function for value of sigma 1 and so it tends to 5, and also when sigma is equal to tends to 0.1, sigma is equal to 0.1, the Dirac delta function value will also tends to 5 like this. Before going to evaluate the Dirac delta function, first we will discuss the theory of this function. A function of the form fx equal to a e to the power minus x minus b whole square divided by 2c square. This type of function is called a Gaussian function. Here a, b are called the real constants and c is a non-zero value. And if you plot the graph of this function, then the shape of the Gaussian function will be like this. Here a is the height of the peak, this height, and b is the position of the center of the peak, this position, and c is the standard deviation, or you say the Gaussian RMS width. This Gaussian RMS width value is called your c value. We know a Gaussian function represented in terms of probability density function of a normally distributed random variable with expected value mu equal to b and variance sigma square equal to c square can be represented by this function. That is gx equal to 1 divided by sigma square root of twice pi e to the power minus half x minus mu divided by sigma whole square. And remember, Dirac delta function, that is delta x, can be represented by the Gaussian function as delta x equal to limit 1 divided by sigma square root of twice pi sigma tends to 0 e to the power minus half x square divided by sigma square. And this is the nature of this Dirac delta function. If you plot the Dirac delta function, then this will be the nature of the Dirac delta function. And there is a shifting property of the Dirac delta function. The function shifts out at x equal to a like this. Integration from minus infinity to plus infinity fx delta x minus a dx equal to f a. So if you write Dirac delta function by replacing x with x minus a, then the function will be like this. This will be the Dirac delta function. And if you, from the shifting property, if you write the Dirac delta function delta x minus a, what is given in the question, then it will be equal to f a. And if you take f x equal to x plus 3, in the question it is given f x equal to x plus 3 and a equal to 2. So if you take f x is equal to x plus 3 and a equal to 2, then the Dirac delta function will be equal to 5. If you calculate this value from the shifting property, then that will be equal to 2 plus 3, which will be equal to 5. And we will try to find out the or evaluate that this Dirac delta function by using Scilab, and we will show that if sigma tends to 1, or you may write sigma equal to 1, not tends to 1. When sigma equal to 1, the value of the Dirac delta function will be equal to 5. When sigma is equal to 0.1, the value also will be equal to 5, like this.
To evaluate the given Dirac delta function, you write the program in the Synode. To switch Scilab function, you write functprot. First, you define the function, then write the given Dirac delta function. First, I have taken sigma value equal to 1 and the limits of integration from minus 10 to plus 10. In the previous video, I have told you how to evaluate definite integral by using Scilab. In Scilab, if you want to evaluate definite integral, then you use the function INTG. INTG is an inbuilt function in Scilab to evaluate definite integral. While writing the coding for the given Dirac delta function, you should use some functions like square root, which is sqrt, and for pi, that is percentage pi, like this. After save and execute, you will see that the value of the Dirac delta function will be 5. You can see it. Now we will evaluate the given Dirac delta function for value of sigma 0.1. If you substitute sigma value is equal to 0.1 in the given Dirac delta function, then also you will find the value of the Dirac delta function is equal to 5. After writing the program in the Cynode, you save and execute, and after save and execute, you will find the value of the given function is equal to 5, as you see in this video.
You should remember that why we have taken the limits of integration from minus 10 to plus 10 or small value of x instead of minus infinity to plus infinity, because since the Gaussian function is picked at x equal to 0 and decreases very rapidly for large values of x, that is why we have taken the limits from minus 10 to plus 10 instead of minus infinity to plus infinity. In the next video, we will evaluate the Fourier coefficients of a given periodic function, that is square wave. Thanks for watching.